Okay, so in this training block, we've got long runs for Amsterdam. We've got threshold runs. At this point, only two that I've got scheduled. And just like that, amazing everyone, the Pikes Peak Ascent training block is in the rearview mirror. It's done. I can't believe it. And yesterday's vlog was all about reflecting on the race. That's how I end a training block, okay? Where I process and think and look at the workouts that I did and how did they correspond or correlate to the actual race day effort and how, frankly, I can improve for the future. So that's what yesterday's vlog was. If you haven't seen it, check it out, upper right-hand corner. But now we're looking forward, that's right, to the Amsterdam Marathon on, I'll come back to this in a minute, on October 20th, 2019. And mentally, I only think about one peak race at a time. So I was focused on Pikes Peak the last 6 weeks since July 1st. And now it's in the rearview mirror. It's time to look to Amsterdam, which I just counted is 54 days away. That's crazy. That's not much time, but it's also a relief because lesson learned. Okay, so if you're new to the channel, you might be wondering, and there's a lot of new folks because of the Pikes Peak Ascent and marathon coverage, you might be wondering, wait a minute, Seth, I thought you were a mountain runner, an uphill trail runner, and I am. And that is my number one passion in the long distance running world. But as I like to say, any distance, any surface. I forget who said that first, but meaning I'm not afraid to race on the roads. I would love to race a sea level 5K track race in 2020. That's one of my goals for 2020. But in addition, I'm trying to qualify for the Olympic trials in the marathon by January 31st, 2020, because the Olympic trials for the marathon is, I think, February 29th in Atlanta, Georgia. So that's my goal. I need to run under 2 hours and 19 minutes. And therefore, a couple lessons. My first marathon that I was gonna race in 2019 was gonna be the Cleveland Marathon, but I had an injury. And a couple lessons learned. And we're gonna dive into the Amsterdam training block here in a second, but I'm just trying to catch up everybody that is a new subscriber. I had an injury in late March, early April. So April, May, I was out completely. June, I started to come back from the injury. Basically I was unable to race the Cleveland Marathon. And I think the reason I got injured was because the training block leading up to Cleveland was too long, way too long. It should have been shorter, which is why I'm pretty excited about Amsterdam only being 54 days. But then in addition, I was doing a little bit too much speed work, not intervals, but threshold running on pavement leading up to Cleveland, which I believe helped lead to my stress reaction in my left foot, which was a major bummer, but we worked through it. And sure enough, bone injuries, they do heal. Sometimes it doesn't feel like they're ever gonna heal, but eventually they do. So if you have a bone injury or really any injury, but especially bone injuries, just give it time, let it fully heal. And that's what I did. Remember the phantom pain kind of scared me, but sure enough, since July 1st, I've been able to put in a really solid summer of mountain running leading up to Pikes Peak. But now we are looking to the future with 54 days to go before Amsterdam. And what's crazy is you're looking at the Amsterdam Marathon website right now, I actually didn't register until today because I just didn't know, am I gonna be healthy after Pikes Peak? It's been a kind of a precarious summer of training. Remember, I took some calculated risks leading into Pikes Peak to make sure I arrived at the starting line as fit as possible and as fresh as possible. And sure enough, I arrived healthy, and now I feel confident enough today to hit that register button for the Amsterdam Marathon. So it's official, it's on the calendar. I'm going to Amsterdam to race this marathon and at sea level on a flat and fast course. If you've been subscribed for a while, you know my approach to marathon training and really any distance, okay, but especially the marathon. And I've said it a dozen times, and I'm gonna say it a dozen more times. I believe developing a bigger aerobic foundation is gonna lead to a greater peak later in the training block, meaning your aerobic system, so your cardiac efficiency, your blood circulation, your capillary beds in your lungs, even, what's crazy, the size of your heart. That's right, the longer runs that you do in a training block, you are actually increasing the power, that's the cardiac efficiency of your heart, meaning how much blood can be pumped to your muscles during hard efforts in a race. It goes up. And frankly, I'll just say it, sometimes I'm a little baffled when I see marathon training programs that skip over the aerobic development part of the block, of the training block. Like they go right into anaerobic work or interval work or speed work. And I'm not saying that's not important, but frankly, like you gotta lay that foundation first before you start to, in my humble opinion, before you start to add speed work or interval work. And so for a marathon race, how I approach it and how I will be approaching Amsterdam is, yes, the first 20 miles of the race is important, no doubt. But it's the last 6 miles that really matters. And that's where the aerobic, like if your aerobic system, if my aerobic system is not developed fully to the, you know, as much as I can possibly, as big as I can build that aerobic base, I'm gonna be struggling the last 4 miles, the last 3 miles. And that's the last thing I want for Amsterdam is to go backward. So again, I'm gonna be doing long runs, okay? 20 mile, 22 mile, possibly 23 mile long runs leading into Amsterdam. And not at crazy fast paces. We're talking for me, 7:30 to 8:15 pace per mile. So not bopping along, but just going, just getting that work in, making sure that cardiac efficiency is being developed so that the last 6 miles, the last 10K of a marathon, I can finish strong. Like, mile repeats, 1K repeats, that might help like the last, you know, okay, I'm just gonna say like the last 2 miles, but I'm more concerned about the last 6 miles. I wanna make sure I feel in full control of my breathing and of my leg strength in order to cross the finish line as strong as possible. Now, in addition to long runs, 20 miles, 22 miles leading into Amsterdam, I'm also gonna be doing threshold runs. You all know how much I love threshold runs, where basically you're approaching going anaerobic, but you're not actually pushing through that ceiling, okay? So you don't want your pH levels in your blood to be plunged down too low. And in order to calculate your threshold pace, you take your 5K PR and then divide it by 3, so whatever your mile pace is for a 5K, and then add 20 to 30 seconds to that time. So for me, right now I can run, you know, based on a 5K I did last spring, I can run about 5 minutes a mile for a 5K. So my threshold pace would be 5:20 per mile, okay? So that's how you calculate your threshold running. And then, so I love to do threshold training for half marathons and now marathons, but for Cleveland, I think I did too much threshold training. So I'm probably, most likely, and this is why I only did it in pencil, I'm probably only gonna do 2 threshold runs, a 9 mile and a 13 mile threshold run leading into the Amsterdam Marathon. Why? I wanna arrive at the starting line as fit as possible, as fresh as possible, but also, frankly, healthy. I don't wanna mess around with another injury leading into Amsterdam. Okay, so in this training block, we've got long runs for Amsterdam, we've got threshold runs. At this point, only 2 that I've got scheduled. And then, as far as going anaerobic, speed work, interval work, probably 2 or 3, not much. I need to think about it just a little bit more. Okay, and one specific workout that I will do leading into the Amsterdam Marathon is what I call cresting the hill with 1K repeats, basically, and it's especially important. Now listen, I'm very fortunate because Amsterdam is one of, if not the flattest marathon course in the world. Like, it's very, very flat, but I'm still gonna do this workout where I train myself. So if you're getting ready for Boston, which is pretty hilly, New York, Berlin is flat. Anyway, where basically I'll do 6x1K, so, and it's a gentle, maybe 50 to 100 feet of elevation gain, so not much, but it is slightly uphill. So you should feel it in your legs where I will run basically all out. Not, okay, I shouldn't say all out, but hard. A hard effort where your pH level is being plunged down and then a jog back to the start. But the key is that I want to crest the hill and then do about 30 seconds where I'm running off the backside of the hill. Again, it's very gentle, gentle downhill and uphill. Like you're gonna notice it, but it shouldn't be steep at all. Like your legs, you don't wanna pound a downhill really, really hard. But I just love the resistance of a gentle uphill for 1K repeats. And so that is one example of a specific workout I will do leading into Amsterdam, okay? So long runs, threshold, 2 to 3 anaerobic efforts. I'm tempted to say 2 right now because just based on my experience with speed work in the past, and I just know, again, it's a marathon. Like this is not a 5K or a 10K. Like this is a long effort. Like you just don't need to go anaerobic that much in a marathon training block, in my humble opinion, all right? All right, so I know that was a lot I just threw at you, and hopefully I gave you some specific ideas for what I'm gonna be doing leading into Amsterdam. We could talk all night, all day about training for a marathon. That'll be happening a lot more in the next 54 days. I can't believe it. So canals, keyword is canals for the canals in Amsterdam. I can't wait to go see Amsterdam. I know it's a beautiful city. Experience the culture, run along the canals before the race. So anyway, it's gonna be fun. And yes, we will do a meetup while I'm over there, absolutely. So there's that. Canals, a question of the day. And I've asked this before, but I'm gonna ask it again. Do you have aspirations to race a marathon in the next 365 days? So the next year, all right? And if so, do you have a marathon on your radar? Yeah, let us know. And maybe you're just getting into running. If so, who knows? Maybe it's a 2 or 3 year goal down the road. If so, that is great as well. But let us know what you're thinking as far as marathon racing moving forward. All right, I think that's it for today. And yes, I am gonna throw up 2 vlogs here. On the right is the injury announcement leading into Cleveland. Just as a reminder for myself to stay smart in this training block leading into Amsterdam. And on the left, we're gonna talk about threshold workouts. All right, that's it, folks. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. Thanks for being here. See you tomorrow.